December 2nd, 1995. A night that was supposed to be routine for Canadiens goalie Patrick Waugh was anything but.
Now in the corner, taken by Lariana, makes a pass. Lariana comes in. What a stop! Rebound, score! Igor Lariana, and the Red Wings lead it 1-0. Gives it off, better off, tried to tuck it in front. It was blocked, picked up Lariana. Oh, and they score! Kozlov was all alone. He's wrapped up, able to get loose now. Kozlov, yes, got score!
Patrick Waugh with the arms up in the air, said, I can't see it. Well, there's nothing worse than that. When a goaltender does that, it's like he's blaming his defense for it.
Off cross ice, Eisenman wins it for a score! Stick on the ice! And it's Wayne Johnson, makes it 5-1.
This building's in shock.
With the Red Wings up 7-1, Waugh's frustrations reached a new level after receiving a sarcastic cheer from the Montreal Forum crowd.
Better off 65 feet. Wow, the save gets
Oh, boy. That's to get the hands up in the air. That's not the thing to do.
No. Lariana up behind the net. Sends it out to Fedorov. Score! Sergei Fedorov!
Bingo, bango. Here comes the hook. Have mercy on me.
After allowing 9 goals on 26 shots, Waugh was finally replaced midway through the second period. As he made his way to the bench, Waugh brushed past his head coach, Mario Tremblay. He then confronted team president, Ronald Corey, with the message that he would never play for Montreal again.
Patrick Waugh leaned over and spoke to the president of the Canadiens organization. You can bet that's going to draw some questions after this hockey game.
I didn't hear nothing what he said to Mr. Corey, but if there's any problem, we're going to solve it tomorrow. We've got a meeting tomorrow at 1 o'clock in the room, and we'll discuss about that. And if there's some players who are unhappy with the team, they just have to go see the GM and, we'll make some arrangement.
The Montreal Canadiens made a trade yesterday, during the night. We trade Patrick Roy and Mike King for Jocelyn Thibault, Andrei Kovalenko, and Martin Rosinski.
For Roy, it was a bitter end to his Montreal Canadiens career, but with a new team and a new opportunity, number 33 would thrive in Colorado, winning 2 more Stanley Cups and a 3rd career Conn Smythe Trophy, a record that stands to this day.